More and more Minnesotans are once again working at work, at least in some capacity. And overall traffic data from the Met Council reflects that. Recovering from the stay-at-home orders early in the pandemic and even the latest Omicron surge in January, putting us just 5% below pre-pandemic levels. But rush hour traffic is another story.
We're still seeing like the morning congestion is really almost non-existent, and the afternoon is probably still only about a quarter of maybe what it was prior to the pandemic.
Brian Carey is Director of Traffic Operations for MnDOT and says even the parameters of rush hour itself has changed.
We certainly seen like the afternoon even kind of shift a little bit earlier, where we're seeing like maybe the 2 o'clock hour being a little bit heavier and then things kind of dissipating sooner.
An analysis of MnDOT and Met Council data by the Star Tribune found that the afternoon window of peak rush hour traffic on I-94 is now an hour shorter than it was 2 years ago. And the morning window is 45 minutes shorter.
The obvious question is why?
It might kind of show that there's maybe a shift in travel patterns out there, that maybe people are returning to work, but they're not necessarily, you know, maybe working that full day from the office.
Heat maps from across the metro show that overall, those trends might depend on where you live, with traffic tending to be heavier in the East Metro. But Brian says no matter where you look, it seems to be spread more evenly throughout the day.
We're still seeing that midday traffic is maybe even heavier than it was before, but not to the point of being congested, just more traffic volume.
Does that make you more confident that maybe behaviors themselves are changing more long-term?
I think so. I think people are realizing that, hey, I'm avoiding all this traffic. It's making my commute a lot easier and my life a lot easier. They just telework a few days out of the week or maybe avoid those peak hours. That can have a real significant impact on reducing congestion on the system.
The question now is how flexible will employers continue to be? And if MnDOT is any indication, the road ahead may be clear for a while.
I've been kind of more part-time, coming in a couple times a week.
So at least here, it's not going anywhere?
Well, I mean, that's hopefully the case anyway. I think, you know, from a traffic management standpoint, it's kind of a dream come true, so to speak, in that we can really kind of help mitigate some of the congestion by pushing some of these strategies where teleworking can help the overall system for us.
Now, here's the thing. Just because traffic congestion is better doesn't mean the roads are safer. We've talked about it here before, but MnDOT says speed is still a big problem at all times of the day, and that means accidents haven't let up. In fact, they generally involve more serious injuries because, again, they're not happening in close quarters. No bumper-to-bumper fender benders.
That's why we see all these speed enforcements now that's got to slow down. Yeah. All right, interesting stuff. Thanks so much, Kent.